Okay, here we have a Smart Notebook file. I downloaded this from Smart Exchange. It looks like a third grade classroom file that's used to take attendance. So my guess is that put this up in front of the screen. These are the kids' names in the class, and they can come up and tap their name to indicate that they are present that day. And then any of the snowflakes that are left is a good chance that those kids are not in school that day. Now, if you're in a situation where you're going to be moving from Smart Notebook to some other technology, you're going to want to go to File, Export As, PowerPoint. And I made a folder just called PowerPoints from Smart, and that's going to allow me to just kind of keep organized as I go through my Smart Notebook files. So it's going to save it as a PowerPoint file. I click Save. So now I was able to export that Smart Notebook file as a PowerPoint. So let's pull that up and take a look at it. Here it is. I'm going to open it in PowerPoint, and we can see the kind of comparison that is going to be taking place. So it looks slightly different. We notice that all the pictures are in the same spot, but the typeface, the font, is actually, it's set to Comic Sans, but it wasn't Comic Sans yet. And you might have to do a little rearranging, changing the size to try to get it back to the spirit of that original doc to kind of make a comparison between the two. Now this PowerPoint file, when I go to present it, when I click present, if I click on any of these names, it's just gonna advance the slide. They are not like objects that will fade away. But we can fix that. We can change that in PowerPoint. You do. Unfortunately, that doesn't come over in the export, but we can add it back. So the key here is to first figure out what is the name of each one of these images. When they got put into the PowerPoint file, they were probably just real generic names like picture one, picture two, picture three. So to find that, you can go to the select and go to selection pane. And here is a list of everything that's on the page, and this one here is picture one. If I click this one right here, it's picture 13. And that's gonna be helpful. So let's start with picture one. Now that I know it's picture one, I'm gonna go to animation, and I want, when that picture is clicked, I want it to disappear. So I want it to disappear, and I'm gonna have it fade away. So now it fades away. But I want it to fade away when it is clicked. So when I click on this picture, and remember it's picture one, then I want it to trigger that fadeaway animation. So we use something in the animation panel called trigger on click of picture one. So now if we were to do this, we go to the presentation mode, and you will see that if I click anywhere on the slide, it just advances to the next slide. But if I click on the image, then it's gonna fade away. I would have to repeat that trigger setting. I'd have to do it for all the snowflakes on here, but once that's in there, then it's set up. And of course, you can go back and edit the names and things like that. And I think that this is gonna get you very close to the original functionality that you had in the Smart Notebook file. So give it a shot.